special guest this evening is Tina Starr from the Rock Pit Show. Tina, well, how you doing tonight?
Great, thank you.
And what's with your show? Where does it, you know, where does it air, or what time, or who do you have on your show?
Well, tonight we're gonna have, I'm gonna throw a little special there for you with Jupiter Green.
Jupiter Green?
Yes.
They out of this world?
Happening band, let me tell you.
Really?
They wouldn't be here if they weren't.
Can you get them here?
They will be here.
Oh, great.
Now, I can get them
last here. Week I had some guy that his name was Star something.
J.I.
DJ Star.
J.I. Star.
J.I. Star. I can't get his name straight somehow.
That's okay, neither can I.
And he was, you're not related?
No, definitely not.
Now, he has his own show, too. What was his show?
Hit Records Nightlife Video.
Hit Records Nightlife Video.
Yes.
I was on his show, too.
Were you?
His show is really kicking.
Yeah, well, what about mine?
And your show is really kicking.
Yeah, I'll have you on my show.
You will?
Definitely.
Okay.
Can you play rock music?
I can rap now.
You can rap. Yeah, I saw you last week with the hat and everything.
I had stuff all over, and it was pretty,
yeah. Happening. I liked your gold medallion, by the way.
You like that?
Yeah. Did you find it?
Yeah, it's somewhere here. Yeah. I paid a lot of money for that somewhere. Now, let's see. You're not related to him. He has his show. You have your show.
Right.
And you have
my show is basically a rock show. I'm a host, and I have rock videos, and I'm in the process right now of promoting local bands.
So the bands, now wait, I get this straight like I had it with DJ Star
J.I.
Guy. Yeah, him too. The stuff we see on your show, we wind up seeing on the New York shows months later, right? So in other words, they see all this talent is on your show first.
We get the videos
and DJ Star's show first, and then it goes to New York. Which is right across the river for those people who don't know where.
Yeah, basically, and it's a little. Yeah, we get the videos and we play them that day. That way, they're new and they're fresh as usual.
So,
no repeats at all, and it's, you know, first seen on our show.
And then it's
our
seen.
Shows.
So if people that watch your show,
we're
shows,
ahead of MTV, and we're going to keep it that way.
I was trying to get that out. I knew it was something because Star DJ guy, yeah, him too, told me the same thing, and I just got it all mixed up.
No, we're ahead of MTV, and we're going to keep it that
so
way.
So now, if we have Jupiter Green, I didn't know Jupiter was green, but when we have them
You'd be
here,
surprised.
When we have them here, then they'll have them in New York months later, right?
They'll be on.
So we're discovering
later.
Them first, then.
Oh yeah, they will be seen here first.
Well, that's all right. I can't wait to get
you're
them
lucky
here. I like a lot of noise.
Oh, they're great. They're absolutely great, and they're coming out with the second CD that should be out shortly.
Very good. You know, I'm gonna get my own CD, my own rock, my own crap music.
We can hook you up.
Yeah.
We got a lot of connections in the record industry. Sure.
All right, because I think I could be into that because I was kicking and what was I doing? I was doing something.
You were
else.
Doing a little rap.
I was kicking and I was chilling and
you
I was
doing good.
I was doing all that stuff. So it was pretty good.
I enjoyed
so,
it.
So is there anything else before we throw you out or
throw me out?
I mean before you leave. I keep thinking I gotta throw people out.
My show's on Monday nights, Vision Cable, TCI, and Manhattan. And we're aired on Monday nights, Vision Cable, at 11 o'clock, Channel 12.
So there we have it. So that's.
And maybe Mike could be my special guest star.
There you go. And then you'll see me. So that's Tina Starr from Live.
The Rock Pit
Rock
Show.
Rock Pit Show. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mike. Thank you.
We're going to be right back.
My mother said I was too much trouble, so she threw me out. I wish I could go back home. If they take me, I just don't know what else to do.
Wherever you are, Covenant House can get you help. Call us on the 9 line. It's free. 1-800-999-9999.
Covenant House.
Thank you. Welcome back. We have a special guest here, another special guest, Great White Hunter, who was brought in, Inspector Stradivarius brought him in to help crack the case looking for Tony. But here with me is the Great White Hunter, and what was your code name?
Code name Albatross.
The code name Albatross. Now, I heard you were looking for Tony where? South America?
Well, I've been throughout Costa Rica, Venezuela, in search of this man. And I'll tell you, the Loch Ness Monster, piece of cake. Bigfoot, Sasquatch, cake. This Tony character, he's got me.
You have any evidence of Tony?
Well, yes, I do, actually. I have this. It's actually still wet. I brought this in on a plane with me today. It's still got some of his spit drew on here.
Oh, yeah.
We had our scientists do a little study on it. We know it's him.
That's Tony. That's
you
Tony.
Can tell here by this small indentation,
you know,
of his
see, mine,
tooth.
I don't chew mine, and Tony chews his.
That's correct.
So, that's, so he really...
Actually, it's hard to tell which side he lights the way he does.
Yes, I know.
This one's wet.
Well, he's a tough guy. He chews his cigars sometimes. When they get little, he just chews them right up. Now, tell me, I heard you were having a little psychological problems with this case.
Well, I tell you, in most of my cases, I don't seem to have a problem. But in this particular case, I'm eating, I'm drinking, I'm sleeping this Tony character. I'm trying to find him. And I tell you, people are starting to look like this guy. I'm seeing animals. I'm seeing reindeers with cigars in their mouth.
That look like Tony?
Jesus Christ. There it is right there. Take a look. Right there. Did you see that? Did you see that?
Well, yeah, I seen it. does this happen often? Do you see these things often?
I see them all the time. Ever since I started to look for them, there it is again. There he is again.
Where? Well, listen. Listen. Do you think you should be taken off this case?
No, I can't sleep. You're trying
to crack the case, or you're cracking up. I mean, what is the?
I will solve this case. I'll tell you. Tonight I brought with me someone that I feel will find this Tony.
Oh, you told me about this special weapon that you have. Now, before we bring the special weapon,
okay,
we're going to get inspected.
Wait a minute. There it is again. I think
we're gonna have to get the repair.
I'm losing it
here.
I'm telling you, I see that guy.
I think we got a big problem now. We got air conditioning where we didn't have it before.
I'm sorry about that. Don't worry about it.
You fix the wall there?
All right. I'll straighten it
so
out.
So we're gonna come right back with Inspector Stradivarius, and we're gonna talk about this other thing
okay.
that you're gonna be going on. So stay.
I think I see him in the crowd out there.
We're gonna be right back after these words.
So how's your cousin's new car?
Oh, yeah, my cousin's new car.
Yeah,
he picked it up last week.
All right.
Big celebration.
Yeah?
You know, I felt like a jerk telling him he should take a taxi home because he had one too many.
But you did.
No, I didn't.
What happened?
Totaled.
What?
Yeah, and him with it.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Take the keys, call a cab, take a stand. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
Thank you. Welcome back to the Mike and Tony Show. Today we got three kids here that we're going to talk to in just a minute. And these guys, you're going to help us find Tony, right, later on? And what's your name?
Corey Martin DeFrancis.
Say that again?
Corey Martin DeFrancis.
Yeah, all right. And your name?
Marissa J. Rinaldi.
And your name?
Erica
Stata Starback. Oh, yeah? Oh, how nice. Now, you got a song you're going to sing, right?
Yeah.
Now, you know what show you're on, right?
Yeah.
What's the name of the show?
Barney.
No.
Mike and Tony.
You get 2 points, you lose a point. So we're writing this all down. All right, now you're going to sing a Barney song?
Two Barney songs.
Mm. All right, go ahead. You sing. I'll back up out of the way. Go ahead, sing. In show business? How long have you been singing these songs? And how long have you been singing?
For a couple of minutes? Yeah.
Well, that's long enough. Now listen, we just heard where Tony
times.
Is. Now you know Tony's missing, right?
Yeah.
Well, we just heard that he's somewhere down in Disney World. He He's selling cotton candy. That's what they told me. We may have to send you down there with Inspector Strat to find him. Do you think it'd be okay if you went?
Maybe if I can go next Christmas.
Next Christmas?
I'm going maybe
you
next
don't,
summer.
You don't think you could go sooner than that, huh?
I can go right now.
You can go right now, even
me
if
too.
You don't ask your mother?
Yeah,
well, me too.
All right, well, we're going to talk.
Me too.
All right, well, we're going to talk to Inspector Strat, and we're going to see what he wants to do. And if we need you to help us and go down to Disney World, you could do that, right? Look at the camera now.
Where's Disney World?
Where is it? I don't know. It used to be
there. It's in Florida.
Yeah, it used to be in California, and they slid it over to Florida. You know?
I went to Disney.
You know Disney? Who's there? Daffy Duck?
Daffy. Donald Duck, Mickey Mouse,
Minnie Mouse,
and they have shows down there.
They do? Well, maybe we could go down and sing for them.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You look at the camera and say goodbye, because we're going to go now. Goodbye. We're going to be back right after this word. Thank you. Atta, wait.
When your employees train with the National Guard and Reserve, they learn to be better team players, better decision makers, and better leaders. It's training that makes them better at serving our country. And better when they come back to work for you.
Bill's back.
Be a hero. Give your employees the freedom to protect ours.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome back to the Mike and Tony Show. As you know by now, we're sending a bunch of little children along with Inspector Strat and the Great White Hunter down to Disney World. And we have some more people. As a matter of fact, I'm going to introduce you to the father of three of these children right now. Pop, your name is?
Gilbert.
Your last name?
Bell.
And you've given us permission to take your children to Disney World?
I was kind of hoping you would, yes.
But you're not coming?
No, I'm going to take my own vacation, I think, this time.
Oh, how nice.
Yes.
Okay, now who do we got here? What's your name?
Macon.
What is it?
Macon.
Macon. And you lost your shoe somewhere, right? Look into the camera and say, no, you're going to go to Disney World, right?
No.
Okay. Well, maybe she won't go. And what's your name?
Ashley.
And your daddy's over there, right? And you're going to Disney World? Why are you going to Disney World?
After we're going to go find
Tony.
Tony.
See, at least you've been paying attention. That's very important. And your name?
Gilbert Bob.
Okay. And you're going to go to Disney World also?
Yeah.
With your father and your sisters?
Yeah.
And why are you going to go there?
To see Tony.
You're going to go to see Tony. And this little one over here, she's waking up.
Tell him Gabon.
Gabon.
Oh, okay. Now we have another one here. And your name is?
Annie.
And Annie, you're going to go to Disney World also?
Yeah.
And your parents gave you permission to go down and help look for who?
Tony.
So you're going to go look for Tony too?
Mm-hmm.
Well, okay. So as you can see, along with the other children, we're sending a very large group down to Disney World, and hopefully we'll be able to find Tony. As you know, we hear he's selling cotton candy down there, and we're going to see what happens same time next week. So we're going to be back right after these words. Thank you. Thank you, kids. You did a great job. Thank you. Give me a hand. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, they give you five. Give me five. Great. Thank you.
All right.
Okay.
Planning a trip to the West New York, New Jersey area? Don't forget to write the Mike and Tony Show for free tickets. That's the Mike and Tony Show, 6701 Bergen Line Avenue, West New York, New Jersey, 07093.
Okay, we're here with Aunt Minnie now. Aunt Minnie, as you know, has been on the show once in a while for cooking. And Aunt Minnie, tell me, why do you want to... Now, this is your child here, Aunt Minnie? Yes, this is my child. This is my love child. Why do you want to go to, why is it that you, Why do you want to go to Disney World? Or why do you want your child to go to Disney World?
Well, because I want to go to Disney World. I've never been to Disney World, and I want to go to Disney World. Oh, is this type of tidy? Oh, yeah, I want to go to Disney World.
So you want to go with the child? Is
well, you know, I kind of have a crush on Inspector Stratus.
Oh, I see. You have a thing for Inspector Stratus? Is that what you're saying?
Right. You know, it's me and Inspector Strat, you know, this is why we have this love child. So that's why we want to go to Disney World, okay?
Well, there you have it. Aunt Millie insists on going to Disney World with the entourage that we're sending with Inspector Strat and the Great White Hunter. So be with us next week and find out what the heck happens down in Disney World with Tony selling cotton candy and his whole tribe going down to try to break them loose.
I do it, boy, be did you with the diaper. Oh, life is the gone, baby.
Okay, we'll be back right after these messages. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Jeff Moore from Jeff Moore and the Distance. You know, when I used to think of the Salvation Army, I would think of bells in front of shopping malls at Christmas time and shelters in the poor part of town. But I have learned there's so much more. What is the Salvation Army? Who are these people in uniform and what do they do? Well, they care about the lost children, missing persons. They provide daycare and night care and aftercare. They give aid to people. And they comfort people with AIDS. They house people. They help restore their self-respect. And they point them in the right way to go. They are who they are because they are called. See, it's a matter of the heart. A heart to God and a hand to man.
A heart to God and a hand to man. Here begins the healing of our land.
If you'd like to find out more about the Salvation Army, just give them a call. There's one near you, and I'm sure you'll find friends there, just like I did.
So how's your cousin's new car?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, my cousin's new car.
Yeah.
He picked it up last week.
All right.
Big celebration.
Yeah?
I felt like a jerk telling him he should take a taxi home because he had one too many.
Yeah, but you did.
No, I didn't.
What happened?
Totaled.
What?
Yeah, and him with it.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Take the keys. Call a cab. Take a stand. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
Thank you. Thank you. We're back with Inspector Stradivarius. As you know, he went to Istanbul last week. Strat, what happened with Istanbul?
I looked all over the damn country for Tony. I couldn't find him. By the way, I was right. The gravy was terrible over there.
Was it, huh?
Lots and lots of turkey there.
They did?
Yes.
No stuffing, though?
No, no stuffing. I had this stuff look like little tiny cockroaches, but I didn't want it.
So now, what is this? I hear we have some more... this is one of your most agents that's out there in the
field? Agent Hooping Crane.
He's a very active agent.
Oh, he's all over the world. All over the world. Got one.
From where was that?
New Mexico.
Hi, Senor Mike. No see Tony. Here in New Mexico. Better check the old Mexico. The pizza tamales are great. Whooping Crane.
And he sent us another one from Texas.
Howdy, Mike. None of the cowboys, cowgirls, or cows have seen Tony. Texas Ranger's been looking. Maybe the Indians got him. Whooping Crane.
This Whooping Crane, he really gets around. Okay, and what is the latest word on Tony?
Well, I think he's in Disneyland.
Disney World or Disneyland?
All right, Disney World.
Disney
World. That's right, Disney World. Sunshine State, you know?
Now, do you think that if we use some of those kids that are out there in the audience as a diversion?
Great covert operation with the young ones, you know? Never
would be expecting anything.
One of the Great White Hunter, what was his code name again?
Albatross.
Albatross. He has his secret weapon with him that will be just going great. So we can take all the children. We can take those three, and Aunt Millie's got one. You can take that one, too. Bring them all down to Disney World. And
lovely.
I don't know how lovely, but that Aunt Millie is a little freaky.
Well, I'm familiar with Albatross's work. Oh, you know, I've seen him bag quite a few in his time, you know.
So you're going to get together and...
Oh, yes. We're going to talk about, you know, the whole operation, you know, because it's like, you know, like a three-hour flight.
All right, now, can we... now, I think we have him ready. Can we get the... why don't you come on back here with your secret weapon? And this is... Now, if you're going to take him with you.
Yes, he'll be traveling with me. And, of course, the youngsters, you know, and...
So, now, I understand this fellow's a mercenary. Is it, you think it's necessary that you have a mercenary?
Well, you never know what to expect, you know. There's a lot of daffy characters down there, you know.
Come on right out here and show us your secret weapon and bring that mercenary out here.
I'll tell you now, since I'm going to Disney, I got to bring someone small in for this job.
So this, now, is he really a mercenary, too?
This is Inspector Rooster.
Inspector Rooster? Well, Inspector Rooster, what do you think about going to Disney World?
I want to go to Tony.
Really? Really? You know, that really floored me. I didn't even know this kid could talk. And is that, do you know how to fire that weapon over there?
Yeah, come here.
All right, let him have it. Wait, you better stop that because we're really putting too many holes in this place.
Well, the rooster, he supports the NRA.
You do? Very good.
I believe what we'll do is we'll send him out in Disney.
Okay.
We'll have him with the old wallet on a string trick.
Okay. And you're gonna
get Tony.
You're gonna have
for the wallet, boom, we'll get him.
You're gonna take
we're gonna stuff a few cigars in his pocket, you know?
And you're gonna take the other three kids and you're gonna take the kids. Sorry about the cigar there for the little guy.
That's all right.
I don't want to stump his growth, you know.
He just quit, he just gave it up himself.
Okay, do you like the microphone there?
Yeah, it's great.
Okay, all right, well, I guess you guys are gonna be off with Aunt Millie and those other three kids and you're gonna stick around for Jupiter Green, those guys? You like that?
Oh, he loves Jupiter Green.
All right, you love Jupiter Green?
Yeah.
Well, hang in there and get your earplugs. Here we go. Okay, we're gonna be right back after
all
these
right,
words.
Rooster.
Thank you.
Hey, folks, for free tickets to the Mike and Tony Show, please write The Mike and Tony Show, 6701 Bergen Line Avenue in West New York, New Jersey, 07093.
My special guest this evening, ladies and gentlemen, we've all been waiting for, Jupiter Green.
Carry me away to
Thank you. Thank you. We're here with Jupiter Green. After hearing them, I figured out why they call him Jupiter Green. Now, tell me, guys, who's your influence in your music?
Our influences are varied. It really, we all come from four different places musically in our development, and our influences are so widely varied. We think it comes through in the music, actually.
And how long you guys been together?
About a year now.
And what's your name?
My name is Kyle.
And where are you from?
Fort Lee.
And your name?
Chris from Fort Lee.
Oh.
I'm Ronnie from Fairview.
Kevin from Fort Lee.
But you guys are really very good, and you've got your own CDs out?
Yeah, we currently have our own self-titled CD out with 9 tracks on it.
Give your P.O. box.
Okay, our P.O. box, Jupiter Green, P.O. box 3061, Fort Lee, New Jersey, 07024. For information on mailing list, upcoming shows, and availability of CDs. And future cable TV shows.
And I can tell you, even though I'm an old person compared to these guys are kicking.
Your help is needed to find these missing children.
File number 431, Laura Beth Hotzler, disappeared in Stuart, Florida, February 25, 1994. She has blonde wavy hair and a small scar on her forehead. Robert Paul Lard, Jr. is missing from Berwick, Maine. He's 6'1", has blue eyes and dark blonde hair. File number 432.
If you have any information about these children or would like to make a much-needed donation, please call or write the Missing Children Help Center.
Sure, not how I thought it was going to be. A lot of times, I don't get anything to eat. I had a friend who died out here. See, I had to leave. My dad, he beat me. I can't go home.
Wherever you are, Covenant House can get you help. Call us on the 9 line. It's free. 1-800-999-9999.
Covenant House.
Gotta go. We're out of time. We'll see you here next week. Same time. Thank you.